Hello, this is Dimitri with UGears US. Today we're going to be doing a new model. It's a model Wolf01 handgun. Just received it in stock, start selling it, this is one of the simpler models, so I'm going to do this one next until moving into more complex models. As I mentioned before, I'm going to try to do the videos of everything that we sell, but it's coming slowly because some of the models do take a lot of time out of the day to put it together. Let's start with this one. It is retails at $24.90 on our website. As I mentioned, we just got them in stock. It's actually pretty cool. I've seen it in action, and now I'm gonna try to assemble one myself and, as always, go through some tips, tricks. This one's got 60 components, so it's pretty easy. Should be easy to assemble, should be pretty simple. According to the manufacturer, it takes about an hour for the assembly. So let's see what we have inside the package. Do have some rubber bands. Do have two plates, two boards, and instruction manual. So we don't need, there are no toothpicks in this model. And although there's some pictures of it shown here. So first, let's go through the regular warnings and legend that you might see through the manual. First one here, it's that we need to, if you see the little toothpick with the candle and the gear, now we need to wax the parts. For that, we just use a regular tea candle. Here I have one available. If you see the exclamation mark, that's you need to pay attention to make sure that certain parts are inserted properly or whatever the reason is, maybe mirror image. But you might see those throughout the instructions. Freely moving components, that's a little fan with errors there. Sand to remove the burrs, sandpaper to remove the burrs. I use for that purpose, I have a precision file. You can use sandpaper. Another good tool is just a regular nail filer, also work. And I do have also X-Acto knife to cut some components out. And the last legend symbol is the location of the additional parts. So here on picture on that page three shows the location of those additional parts with that symbol. So if you look at the boards, there's a board number one and no board number two. I'm holding in my hands board number two, and you got some additional parts. It says 24 plus right here. Then there is a little space right here. The parts have the plus sign next to it, so that means it's additional. And then on board number one, there is a, let's see, right here, 26 plus and 15 plus. So you have a couple of those extras in there, just in case if you break them during the assembly or after the model is assembled and operational. Also, don't forget, if you break any other parts, components, just send me email. As long as the part was purchased from me, I will send it from a US warehouse, which takes about 3 to 4 days for the delivery. I will need the picture of this little distribution sticker on the back of the box. Just to prove it that you bought it through me or one of my affiliates. Otherwise, I will order the part from the manufacturer, which usually takes about a month for delivery, or the small expedited fee. I can ship it from my warehouse, so there's going to be only a shipping charge. I don't charge for parts. For that, just send me email at info@ugears.us, or you can go on my website, go to info support and find the information there under part replacement program. So let's go ahead, continue with the model. We're gonna start, we need a board number one, so I'm gonna put two aside. And step number one, we need part number, let's see, three, four, and five. So let's look for those on the board. And here's the part number three. Another tip, hint that I usually provide is that there is a front face on the board and there is a back face. So we usually push from the back towards the front. That way the burrs, little fibers will stay on the attached to the part and will they peel off the board. If you try to do the other way, it's gonna go, they're gonna peel off the part and it's not gonna have a nice look. So once again, we go from the back towards the front. Usually I look for the connection points and I press down around them. That will help you separate the wood, or you can use the X-Acto knife to pre-cut, find those connection points and pre-cut them. So this is, let's see, part right here we can remove. And the parts that I'm removing from the components, from internal part of the component, I will do it from the other way. I'm doing it from the front, because you want the bigger piece to stay intact. Or in this case, the fibers will peel from the wood that you don't use. So here you go. This is also part, which is number 10. So make sure you don't throw it out and keep it intact. So we're gonna have this, and then we need numbers fours and fives, which there's a number fours and five. I just pulled out these guys. So we need 1 4. I'm gonna pull it off. So once again, it's if you're okay, you can push it out with your fingers, or you can use X-Acto knife, like in this example. I go from the front face, I find the connection points, and I kind of just pre-cut them a little bit. And then when you try to push it out, it will come out much easier. So that's two ways to push the parts out. Another way is to use any helper tool. So you could use another piece, the component or the part that you used already, and you just push it out, kind of put a pressure across it. So number five goes with a slot. I guess in the vertical axis, insert it into the left hole, then goes to, there's two holes right here towards the center, so you go to the bottom one, and then number four, you go the one all the way on the right. So, and let's see, you push them all the way in. And then, in this case, I'll use these boards to help me a little bit to push it out. So try not to break them. But I'm assuming the tight fit is that it does need to stay together. So we do need to use a little bit of sandpaper. In my case, I don't have it. So I'll try to use the file. Good thing I have a flat portion on it. So I kind of sand down the surface here just to make sure there is no burrs, because that's going to be against the moving component. So all the way around the trigger opening right here, sand it a little bit. And then use the candle. In my case, I'm going to use, just peel it off a little bit, put it on the board, and then apply it all around. So as you touch it with your fingers, because it's a candle wax, it's gonna melt down a little bit, but don't melt it too much, or you don't need to melt it too much. You don't want it to get absorbed by wood. So you want it to stay on the surface rather than get absorbed. So all around the trigger area here. Mm-hmm. that's where the moving mechanism will be. Now we need part number one, which is the larger piece right here. And I keep on forgetting that I need to keep my hands above the table rather than under the table. So there's a piece right here, and they need to pull it aside. That's number 12, so 10, 12. And then let's see, separate all the other pieces that are pre-cut. So there's number 7 here. I still have it attached to the board. And then pieces number 29. So now I have this part. I do need to wax sand this surface and this surface. A little bit. And then, so with the caliber 1.5 by 60 facing towards you. Let's see, I need to, there's one slot, two slots, three slots here. Put it through the parts number 2.5s and 4 that you just inserted in there. So down, and then moving on to the next step, number 3. Here we look for part number 2, which is located also on board number 1, right here, that little weird piece. Push it out, looks like it's pretty fragile, so just be careful not to break it. And then that one, you need to wax this piece right here and this portion. I'm gonna sand it down a little bit because there's a connection point here, so put a little bit in here, and then use the candle wax to get it on this part, on these two little lips. And that piece goes with the longer lip towards the top, right here into the slots that are pre-cut right for it, so you won't miss it. It's a kind of two round slots. So you need to wiggle it around to get it inside there and slide it all the way in. Now the next step is number 4. We'll look for part number 6, which was right next to number 2 here. It's a part kind of like a C-shaped, I guess, with a little lip. And if you have trouble pulling it out, use the X-Acto knife. And that one goes with the slot cut out towards the top. That's the exclamation mark here. And you slide it into the hole. I do need to wax it a little bit on the side. So once again, there's a couple connection points in here. So I'm just clean them off a little bit. Put a little bit tiny amount of wax here. And then, so make sure the slot is towards the top, the C is facing to the right, and we need to insert it into that hole right here. So, and separate the wood a little bit. It's shown on the picture here. Kind of pre-insert it. Move it into the slot. And here you go. And then put the top portion back in. So now that part sits right into the proper location. And then we move to the step number 5, where you need number 7, which this piece right here, that was pulled off number 1. So we'll separate the board here, and we need to send it down these two, this long stick, boss extension. So there's a connection point here. I'm gonna send it down all around, or the cut surfaces, this and this, and then the back extension. That is a little thicker, so the same thing, there's a connection point on two sides, so I'm gonna send it out a little bit, and we need to apply wax on those surfaces, top and bottom. So see how useful I found this board with part number 4 in there. Peel off a little bit of wax and then apply it to both extensions on the number 7 piece. And then goes, that piece goes right with a circular cutout towards the top. It gets, so it's a trigger. So I put it right in to make sure that the trigger is right inside the space here. And then you can try to move it back and forth and see if it is smooth. If not, there's a connection point on little part number 2 here. So you might wanna cut those a little bit or work them a little bit more, send them down, connection points on here. So just make sure that you get all the connection points out, that it slides back and forth easily. So we move on to the next step, number 5, or page number 5, and step number 1, we need part 9. So a lot of small pieces here, and 9 is on actually sheet 2. So we're here on the bottom of that sheet, from push it from the back towards the front. And then we do need to send this surface, make sure it's free of burrs, connection points. And get a little bit of a candle wax again and apply it a little bit on both sides. Where the connection points are at, and those are mechanical, so there's going to be movement. We want to reduce the friction. So here, with the little that tip going towards the top, the circular portion fits right into the trigger part, and in between that part number 2, I believe. Correct. So it goes right in here. Should fit perfectly. Then we move to this step number 2, where we get part number 8, which is on board number 2, bottom right. Push it out carefully. There's some parts that you will need to push out of it. Put the board on the side, so you got some additional parts which you can put somewhere on the side because you don't need them right now. Then this little part number 11. So we got 10, 12, now 11. And inside of 11 there is parts number 17 and 18. Push those out too. Gonna keep 11 so I don't mix it up here on the board. So with part number 8, we do need to clean off some surfaces. So a portion right here, get the connection out, inside the trigger a little bit. Also, I'd say, let's see, that lock towards you, so that internal surface also, my assumption, needs a little bit of waxing. And then we do need some wax on these surfaces, as there's some moving parts there, so just put a little bit of wax on the back. And that goes, let me see, down on the bottom here. Make sure unlock is facing you. That way you're not gonna put it in the wrong way. And just feed it into the, into those parts, not what I think it was, 4-4 and or 4-5 and 5, right into the slot. Okay, make sure that if one of the components falls out, put it back in. That's the one with the tip going towards the top. And now I'm gonna press it all the way in to make sure that it doesn't fall out again. So just apply pressure from both sides and that should lock the whole thing in place. All right, already taking some shape. Now we need to press the trigger and see if there is movement back and forth. So press the trigger, pull it forward, and make sure these components move easily and freely back and forth. Now we need two more number fours. Once again, X-Acto knife would be a good choice of tool to pre-cut these a little bit, so it's easier to pull them out. And those go on the bottom here where the magazine would be. So kind of from the side. Attach them right, just like this, like shown on the page number 5, step number 3. There we go. Now we need number 10 right here. We do need number 5. Just pulled it out with my fingers. Then we do number 12 component that is also was on the board number 1. And then with these little, so number 5 goes right in here in the only hole. Then on, right on top you put a number 12. All the way down, make sure that they're all facing the same direction. There's a little tip here, goes towards the left, and then on top of it you put number 11, also in the same direction. So here's your little magazine here, and it's all completed and stamped number 6. Now you need number 14, which is on page or sheet number 2, and this is the one in the middle. So I push it out, there's some fly here, push it out, and then with the gun facing you, the letter R, or towards the right, the letter R is facing you, you insert that number 14 piece where the handle is at, so it's part of the handle. A little tricky on the bottom here because those number 4s are not very secured, but this should go in fairly easy. So you and new gears is facing you on that piece number 14. We move in, move on to page number 6, and step 1, you wax a little bit these two sides. Easier movement back and forth. Turn the gun around and put the magazine right inside there. Make sure there's plenty of lubricant. Work it back and forth. I think I need a little bit more of lubrication on there. I did kind of put enough, but doesn't look like good enough. All right, one more try. All right, feels a little smoother. And then you secure the magazine with a number 13 piece, which is also on sheet number 2. Once again, your gear is facing towards you, and you put it on this little tabs. All right, and it looks like your handle is done. Make sure magazine opens. Will be a little bit stiff in the beginning, but then it'll work itself in as the you play with it more and more. So our handle is ready. Magazine is ready. Next step, I'm gonna put this aside for a second. Step number 4 on page number 6. So we need one of the boards, which is number 16. That's the one that with the letter R. Push it out, and then we need, let's see, parts number 5, 4, 2 17s and 2 18s. Let's see, 17 and 18, they are sheet 2, these parts right here, and then 4 and 5, I still have small leftovers. So on here, letter R facing away from you, we need to wax, sand and wax this surface right here. So I'm going to use my little precision file. Should have got myself some fine sandpaper, but unfortunately I don't have it. So just sand it out a little bit, make sure it feels smooth. And then we need, I'll start pulling one by one, so part number 5. And goes all the way to the most left hole. Make sure it's fully seated. Then part number 4. Work it back and forth to pull it out. That's the next one to number 5. Then 2 18s follow next into the next two holes. And then it looks like there are a lot of connections there, but most of the holes are a little bit diagonal, so you insert the only two that are parallel to the other edges. So two number 17s, go in there. And now we need to wax the surface a little bit. Once again, make sure the letter R is on the back, and then we'll wax the surface. Between the tabs. Now we need need part number 19, which is also on sheet number 2, all the way to the left here. And let's see. So it's a symmetrical part, but make sure that that cutout is towards the right rather than towards the left. So that's the exclamation point on here, and you put it on the little number 18s that you just inserted. So that one also needs a little bit of waxing on the side. So I'm gonna get rid of the little connection points that is sticking out here, just send it down a little bit, top and bottom. And then use a little bit of a wax to get the surfaces. And once again, with a little opening towards the bottom right, and you just insert it onto the number 18s. And then that portion goes on the main assembly from the right side. There's a little slot in the front, and then all the slots, kind of like everything else, falls into the other slots, which are more open. There you go. I'm gonna turn it facing down, and then we need part number 20, which is also board number two. Right next to the 16, and that one has a letter L. So from the back, L facing away from you, this surface right here needs a little bit of sanding down and wax. So I'm gonna use my file sand it down, and then grab a little bit of wax and wax that surface. For the wax, it's just a regular tea candle. I mean, any candle should work. You can also try to graphite, but it has some color to it, so you might not really want to. I have a little bit of wax inside the hole, so I'm going to push it out. Another one is lip balm. Should work, chapstick, and other options. I think that's all I can think of right now, but there's some other options out there. There's special wood lubricants. So now this L facing towards you, you insert it into the corresponding openings. Make sure you match all the holes. Then it should go all in, and you kind of squeeze it from both sides to lock it in place. So we're on page number 7, step number 2. We completed the main assembly. Now we're going into the middle portion of it. We need part number 21. 21 is located on board number the one on the right here. So as you can see, this handgun is getting very detailed. All right, 21, so we do need a little bit of, not sure why you need a wax there, just for it to easier get inserted. But I'm just gonna clean off. I'm not gonna skip the waxing on there a little bit. I'm gonna clean off the connection points so it just looks nicer. Two more. then it's going to be sitting against the stationary part here, so you do need to wax the bottom surface, I'd say. Let's see, so gun facing you, this little tab, T-tab towards the back, and this opening towards right side towards the back. So then I'm gonna wax a little bit the bottom portion right here. Insert it on the top of the gun. That's going in a little bit tough, so maybe that's why they want it to use a little bit of a wax to help you out, but once again, it's you just need to be careful not to break it. But it, all of these should fit fine into all the slots. Make sure it sits all the way flat, and then the top portion moves back and forth. Now the next step, all the way to the right, we use a rubber band, and it says to wax rubber band a little bit. So I'm gonna put a little bit of a wax onto my fingers, kind of sandwich it between the rubber band and run the rubber band through the fingers or through the wax, so it's a little bit smoother, I guess, to insert. Now you need to fold it in half and push it through the hole right here next to the unlock button. So that's the tough portion. Let's see, I'm gonna try. Check a little bit ahead, so make sure if I need to fold it or not. It looks like it's folded here, but it's not, so you just push it through the hole. Let's do that first. You just need to follow the instructions. I'm gonna use my little precision file. You can probably use a toothpick from some other kids, and push the rubber band through that hole, which is probably so far is the toughest task that I have. Make sure you catch it on the other side. So hold the rubber band from the back, make sure it doesn't snip off or slice through, and kind of get it onto first a little tab here on the front. I'm gonna move to the next page, number 8. So I'm gonna come back on the side, go into the top hole there with a full rubber band, push it out a little bit just like this, so I'm still holding it, then wrap it around into the bottom hole, let's see, just trying to figure out, then wrap it around again through the top and the bottom. Exclamation point that you have it correct. Oh, might need that little opening connected to piece number 22, which probably would have been a good idea if I knew that I had to push it out first. Now I'll have to figure out how to hold this. Rubber band, so. Now my 22 is ready. And let's see, I'm gonna make sure that everything is still connected or the rubber band is pulled around the way it was shown. And then I don't think I can pull it that far. So you go. All right, so let's pull the rubber band a little further. So I pull it out from the other side to create some tension. You go through the top hole, hold it down a little bit to make sure on the back, pushing it through the bottom hole, wrap it around through the top again, the bottom, and then at the bottom hole, hold the rubber band, use piece number 22 to grab the rubber band with the little two slots right here. Just, and I let it go. One more time. Now I'm gonna get very good at it. So top, hold it down from the back, bottom, well, not all the way to the bottom, like the middle one, I guess. Then hold it from the top, top portion again, middle, snapped off. So I gotta pull a little bit down so to make sure that it doesn't slide off. There you go. Two loops, probably gonna break the rubber band by the time I'm done. Then insert it into the slots on piece number 22. Push it back. And then snap it with these little tabs right into the place. Now, step number 3 is to make sure the trigger is working. So you see the rubber band here. Let's go back and forth. Here you go. So it needs to work itself in and out a little bit. And as you can see, after a couple of movements, now it's trigger releasing back. And it says you should hear a clacking sound. And it does clack when I let it go of the trigger. Unless they were talking about a different clacking sound, which I don't hear anything else. Here we go. All right, let's see. Now we're to number 23. And we're gonna work a little bit trigger, so number 23 goes on the opposite side and into the little slots right here. Let me see what the diagonal on the bottom right here, so two holes right in the center. To my understanding, the trigger is supposed to I'm not sure if it's supposed to release or not. It does move back and forth as you press the trigger. But I don't hear the clicking sound that they were talking about. So I'm gonna partially disassemble it and see if anything's supposed to be making a clicking sound. So I'm just remove piece number 23. Bend, play around with it later. Won't be able to see anything on here, so I'm gonna go back into the instructions and see if there is something that might be making a clicking sound. Nope. Here we go. All right, so my wasn't moving all the way back. You just need to work it back and forth a little bit. I'm gonna grab back onto the rubber band and install the 22 back. And now it makes the sound. So just need to work it a little bit. Plywood, a lot of friction. So, but now it seems like I got it to work. And that's the clicking sound what we're looking for. So now I can put all the parts back and come back to the step where we're at. So that's the clicking sound that we're looking for. So it releases back. So all I did is I took off 22 and 23, released the pressure from the rubber band tension. Kind of worked it in a little bit with the trigger to make sure that it does make that clicking sound. And then now the kind of like reloads itself, becomes an automatic. Now let's see, next step is number 5. I need piece number 26 and 15 and 25s. So 226 is right here. I'd use the X-Acto knife, find these connection points. To make sure it's easy to pull out. To number 26s. separate them. So 26 goes, so I'm looking on the left side of the gun. 26 goes up front. Two slots there for that. Then number 15, which are pieces right next to the 26. I'm also gonna use the X-Acto knife for that. And the connection points are tabs, and in between is the next to the tabs. So just push those two out with helper tool, or which maybe obviously it wasn't provided in this case, but I'm just using my file. Number 15 goes in the slot right here, right above the trigger. Two holes. And then 25s, which are these pieces right here on a first sheet. These are a little bit larger, so this should come out very easily. We need four of them for this side. And they go with a little flat portion towards the bottom, so they go into these diagonal holes. And make sure you insert them so they're fully seated into these holes. And then we do the same thing on the other side. So I have the 26 goes to the front. Number 15 right above the trigger. It just gives us a little accent, and then we need four more of the number 25. They'll go into the diagonal slots in the back. Again, make sure everything is properly and fully seated. The gun is working now. And we're at the bottom of page 9, bottom right. And the last piece is number 24, which is on the board number 2. There are two of them together. There's one additional just in case if you break one. Once again, I will use an X-Acto knife. I'll cut one out first. And once you pre-cut, it should kind of like fall out very easily. That goes on the top. So with a larger piece toward on the front, and then can insert it. Slide it back a little bit and snap into back opening here. I would use a little bit of a file on top to make it nice and smooth. So we're done with that. Now we're putting together 2, 3, and 4 steps, little targets. They're on page number, or sheet number 1. So it's, this is number 31. 30. We'll make 2 targets, apples. And then number 32s are on the board number 2. So 31, 32 goes where the two little, where the drawing is. So that'll be the front. 32 inserts just like this, all the way down. one of the old pieces just to help me out a little bit, and then number 30 goes into the little slot here. So once again, all the way down, and when you set it, it's going to be a little bit under the angle. It's a pretty neat target. Two of the targets, and then one last piece, step number 5, is part number 27, is on board number 2. Then we need 28s, two number 28s and 29s there, like in the little piece that you had pulled out from one of the handles, I believe. So these should come out pretty easy. I see they are pre-cut very well. They're tiny parts, so careful not to break them. So 28, then 27 is the flat portion, 28 goes into the front and back slots there. Make sure they're same direction. And then 29 from the bottom into the slots. So this little piece attaches to the gun. You can use get a little those laser keychains, attach it here, so there's a little round pieces here, and you can just attach it with a rubber band. It's shown on the right hand side here, and then it attaches to the bottom of the gun right here. Just kind of push it on the pieces. There's a plenty of clearance for the rubber bands, so it's going to sit nice and tight on the bottom of the gun. So kind of like a laser guidance for you. And that's it. So this is the last page. I guess it says use only with glazes. A little misspelling there, but it's getting fixed. There is a locking mechanism here, so there's a safety. It's right, located right here. When you press down, unlock. From the other side, it locks. So when you do lock, you can press the trigger, squeeze the trigger. So unlocking position. Now loading the gun, you have plenty of rubber bands. Let's see, I got in my kit 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So I guess it was a total of 10. Figure it's gonna be plus or minus 1 or 2. And then loading, obviously it's easy. Go from the front, then attach it to the little teeth on the back, starting from the bottom up. You can load up to 5 rubber bands at a time. The rest of the rubber bands, make sure they're not overlapping much. The rest of the rubber bands, I kind of actually all 4 that I got left, wrap them around. So you can use the magazine. And put it right in there. Lock it up. So now we have a fully loaded gun. Have a little target here. And then as you squeeze the trigger, I missed it. There you go. Just go through all 5 rubber bands in no time. So we have fully functioning rubber band gun. Make sure you do use glasses when you play with it. Nice fun little toy. So we're done with the assembly. This was the last of it. If you have any questions, please let me know down in the comments. Or you can send email at info@ugears.us. My website is ugears.us. Please check out all other products that we have available. I am working on the videos to have all the assemblies done. They're going to be showing up as I finish them up. Once again, questions either below in the comments or info@ugears.us. The website is ugears.us. My name is Dimitri, and I'll see you next time. Thank you. Bye.